This is Coffee and Cocktails with MC, a show committed to introducing you to the interesting personalities of our business community in and around Anne Arundel County. Now for today's chat, here's MC.
Mission Escape Rooms, and I'm talking to the owner. This is Jason Cherry. Hello.
Hi there.
And we're going to talk about Mission Escape Rooms and some other stuff too, because you do way more than this. Mm-hmm. And I found it fascinating, all the pies you've got your finger in.
Sure.
So to speak.
Yeah, I like to keep myself busy.
Absolutely. You have two locations.
Yep.
For Mission Escape Rooms.
Two locations. We have a detached, a separate workshop that's designated for building the props and maintaining the locations. Right now we're a team of about 18 employees and rapidly growing.
Okay. Uh-huh. And so you've got the one location in Annapolis on West Street.
Yep.
And then you are here in the new version or village of Wachapel.
Sure. Wachapel 2 is
on
the main street, however.
Yeah, I always just say the new Wachapel.
The newer portion of development, yes. Which, we're on the main street in between the Black House, White Market, and Loft.
Yep. That's what I was going to say. It's offhand. I can't remember the stores that anchor you, but very good. I know when I first learned of Mission Escape Rooms, I wasn't quite certain. Let people know, you are not a franchise. You didn't create the concept, but Mission Escape Rooms, that brand
sure.
is yours, correct?
Yes, that is correct. So the global concept of an escape room or escape game was existing. It was something that originated over in Japan and really took off like wildfire in Europe before it hit U.S. soil. But this concept of Mission Escape Rooms, all of the rooms, the game flow, props, anything you see at any of our locations has all been developed in-house by myself and my team.
Okay, so you don't have to follow anybody else's guidelines or whatever,
nope.
What kinds of rooms they are. That's all from, does that come from your mind or a team of
sure.
creative minds?
It originally came from my mind, and now I'm grateful to say that I employ a very creative team. So at this point, I'm just approving the game plays and making sure that they stick to a budget. But like I said, I employ very creative people. There's never a lack of creative content
right.
that's flying around. And what's unique about us not being a franchise is we're able to come out with holiday-themed rooms. We had Santa's Workshop here at Wachapel, Escape the Nautilus running at Annapolis. We're able to change the themes of the rooms every 6 to 8 months and keep things fresh.
Okay, so that was
sure.
my next question is if and how often you change out the rooms.
Mm-hmm.
Because if someone were to come 1 week and do, I think one of these rooms is Alice in Wonderland?
Yep, so we have Alice in Wonderland and The Inventor here at Wachapel.
If I escape Alice mm-hmm. 1 week and come in a week later,
it will still be the same clues,
right.
same story.
Okay.
Yes, that's correct.
Very, very cool. But then if you're somebody with a short memory or easily confused, it's like a whole new experience every
sure.
time. So that's awesome. Now, with two locations already and in a fairly short amount of time,
mm-hmm.
Less
than 2 years.
Yep. Yeah, safe to assume that you're going to continue to expand?
We are. Right now we are working on our third and largest location in Arundel Mills. That will be a 4,000 square foot facility with 5 themed rooms that will be multi-room escapes. So right now at our existing two locations, when you're locked into a room, you're escaping out of that single room. And you know, we provide a really immersive concept and thought-provoking props. But it'll be a whole nother level of excitement and energy when you unlock trap doors and you go through 3 to 4 rooms before getting out.
I don't get out much, but the only previous exposure I had to something even kind of close to this concept was, it was one of those stupid shows on TV, reality TV show. I want to say All the Strangers in the House. It's not Real World. The new one.
I want to say it was The Real House. Big Bang Theory, I know, had it. And then there was also The Real Housewives. I remember my mom showing me about that.
Yeah, I don't remember. But
sure.
I've seen those, and it seems like you have to be pretty darn smart or, you know, think outside of the box.
Or have an excellent team that you're working with.
Right,
yes, and so that's what's great about the concept for corporate team outings or groups that just want to work together, is that it does, you know, take multiple minds to get out, and some, you know, a lot of communication and working back and forth between multiple props.
Right.
So even if you're not the sharpest one, as long as you have a few people in the room, I think you'll be okay.
Right. So, you said when we were talking before that you get a nice mixture between, you know, you get corporate outings, but you get families, maybe girls' nights, that sort of a thing.
Yep.
I see a lot of pictures on my newsfeed, a lot of people taking the pictures with the ice skate and what have you. So it's definitely a popular
Absolutely.
Night out and weekend thing. What are your typical hours? Because obviously we're here right now and you're not open. We're here during the day. Mm-hmm. I know everyone can get this on the website, but I'm just getting an idea. When are your busy times when you guys open?
So we are open Wednesday through Sunday. And like MC just said, we are shut down right now, but we do very often open up off hours for private parties, corporate events. Yeah, so that is something that we have the capacity of doing and do very often. It's a Tuesday right now. Annapolis is going to be opening up in 2 hours for a large corporate group. So we do have the capacity as long as you get in touch with us ahead of time. But our standard hours open to the public are Wednesday through Sunday. Our busy times are Friday nights, and then Saturday all day.
Yeah.
This location in particular on a Saturday, you know, all of the experiences will be sold out a week in advance.
Okay.
So it's doing very well and taking off, and people are having fun.
Yeah. So we can come back to this, but as I said, you're so interesting. Normally it's not polite to ask a woman how old she is, but I'm going to ask you, how old are you?
21 years old.
Okay. And this is not your first career or endeavor. What have you done before this?
Yeah. So I opened the Mission Escape Rooms concept when I was 19. In 2016 is when I launched my Annapolis location. Prior to that, I spent 2 years professionally auto racing in the Pirelli World Challenge Series in 2014 and 15. I drove for Mazda in 14 and Nissan in 15. So I spent 2 years traveling all over North America driving race cars.
Okay.
I partnered up with the Autism Society of America. My older brother's on the spectrum. And at every racetrack, I would work with a local affiliate to host 100 to 200 kids on the spectrum under our paddock, in the canopy, sitting in the race cars. And so just providing a really awesome experience for them. So racing was where all of my, you know, background came from, and any sort of marketing you see that's tied to Mission Escape Rooms, all that creativity's stemming from the racing. Since then, I've also established Siblings of Autism, which is my nonprofit. It's a local nonprofit. Every year, I run a national scholarship campaign where I ask siblings to submit some sort of content, and then I choose 7 different winners. And my first place winner gets a $10,000 scholarship, and then the scholarships kind of stem down from that.
Okay.
So every year I personally fund $20,000 in scholarships for that nonprofit.
Wow, that's awesome. And you said that's because your older sibling.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So my older brother, Matthew, was adopted from Russia and is on the autism spectrum. When I partnered with the Autism Society of America while I was racing, I had an awesome time working with them and, you know, got to attend their national conferences and speak on many different boards. And what I quickly realized is that they do an awesome job taking care of those on the spectrum, but they're quickly overlooking the siblings that are being directly impacted. If a family doesn't receive that state funding, then they're funding all these services out of pocket, and that directly impacts a non-ASD sibling going to college. So that was what pushed me to establish Siblings of Autism.
That is so awesome. Yeah, I was poking around and I had found, I don't know if there's a website or a Facebook page for that.
There is, it's siblingsofautism.org, and we just launched our 2018 competition.
Okay, very good. Because I think, actually, at this point, many of us either are related to or know somebody who's on the spectrum or who is touched by that, so that's really incredible. And again, at such a young age, to have already found different passions and things that are important to you that you're so involved in. You might have told me, I don't recall, if you don't mind me asking, so young, why did you already get out of racing? Just because other interests or?
Other interests, the one thing that racing exposed me to was big business. When I was driving professionally or aspiring to be a professional driver, I met a lot of big CEOs that were able to do it for fun.
Right.
And that combined with politics that you experience in sports car racing in particular, and that's just the nature of the racing. You have different cars, manufacturers, and platforms, you know, how do you determine, you know, how a Porsche is equal to a Nissan and equal to a Mustang and all these different platforms that are different lengths and engines and wheelbases, how do you make sure that they're the same speed on a track? And it's tricky. And that's a battle that the series is always, you know, working towards. And unfortunately, in my 2015 season, I got the short end of that stick. I went back to a track that I set track record at the year before, and I was 3.5 seconds off of pole position per lap. And when you're doing 150 miles an hour, 3 seconds is football fields on top of each other. And so at that point, I just decided enough was enough, and that I wanted to eventually re-enter racing, but hopefully be able to do that on my own terms.
Okay, and that's something you're still looking at,
yes,
possibly?
Yeah, wow. Sure, absolutely.
I'm gonna date myself here. You mentioned pole position. If I recall, I think that was a video game I used to play when I was younger. It was a racing
game. Might be, sure.
Yeah, no, anyways, sidebar. But you said pole position, I'm like, I know that name. Okay, so you also, when we were talking before, mentioned another endeavor you are looking into doing.
Yep, so I'm actively pursuing the Kilwins franchise. There's one downtown Annapolis off of Main Street that I've had a strong working relationship with our Annapolis location. They are an ice cream, confectionery, candy shop, and I just love the brand.
Yeah.
I think it's a surefire thing. I you know, flew out to corporate, met the owners and everyone that's, you know, big positions out there, and love the people and the brand and their mission. So that is something that I'm actively working on opening a few spots.
I didn't even pay attention, but I know back in the day, I think there was actually one anchoring here.
There is one right here.
Oh, there is?
Yes,
okay.
There is.
So is it too soon to ask where you would be looking to possibly open that up?
We are working on Georgetown right now, and have an offer out on a space in Baltimore for the Inner Harbor. We would be waterfront. Nothing has been set in stone, but that's where we're actively working. Where, you know, we want to place ourselves in a touristy type market where people aren't watching their weight or wallet.
Yeah.
You know, you're not low in calories, so
you
want to make sure you're hitting them when they're out celebrating life.
I think they also have caramel covered apples.
Oh, they have it all.
So that's kind of healthy. I mean, apples, they're fruits. Okay, very cool. So obviously, you're not going to just stop at one thing. And you're always looking and whatever. Say somebody just wants to know, what the hell is Jason up to now? You know, do they just poke around and just keep an eye out for everything?
I would say that would probably be their best bet, yeah.
Yeah, because you're going to start having people be like, okay, so what can't he do? He's race cars, like in a professional, not just like out on the road where the cops got you, race cars, you know, we've got a nonprofit. We've launched our own brand of this unique concept. We're looking at making sweets and confections for people. So and it's so diverse. There's just, you don't even have like this certain track that you're
following. And I like the challenge too. I think that was what also prompted me to pursue the Kilwins, is I had grown the escape room concept to a point where I have an excellent team behind me.
Right.
And it's kind of just cruising along by itself. I'm very involved with new site development and, you know, any sort of marketing initiatives, but I wanted to re-challenge myself. And that's what I enjoyed. I mean, when I got out of racing, I started working for a data analytics marketing firm. So I was in a corporate world. I was 9 to 5 in a cubicle, and I didn't find it challenging.
Right.
And, you know, building the Mission Escape Rooms brand was a challenge at the time, and that's what I thrived off of.
Right.
I mean, I was up at 4 a.m. and wouldn't get home until midnight or sometimes later.
Right.
And I just cranked all day to get stuff done, and I love that. And I felt more recently like I was starting to lose some of that, which is what has pushed me to pursue other concepts and begin to diversify what I'm involved with.
So even if somebody doesn't see you every day in either of the Mission Escape Room locations, you were very involved. I would say a behind the scenes involved. I mean, you are out there, you interact with your employees on a, you know, a regular basis, but you're definitely not one of those people who said, okay, I got it going, and then you're across the country somewhere, and you're very much hands-on.
Yes. And big picture thinking.
Yeah.
You know, I'm hands-on with my management. Like I mentioned earlier, we do have a designated workshop with full-time employees that are building the props, maintaining the rooms and all that.
It's kind of like Santa's workshop.
To a degree. And my staff understand that, you know, if I was here every day taking people into the rooms, then I wouldn't be able to have the capacity to grow the company.
Right.
So everyone's on board. You know, I'm still actively communicating with them and having meetings with them, but they know that for them to grow within the company and the company to grow as itself, that I need to kind of have this big picture thinking
right.
and involvement. And that's what my position is growing towards. And it wasn't always like that. When I opened the company, I was severely in debt, and it was myself and two part-time employees.
Okay.
And I mean, people didn't know what the heck an escape room was
right.
or why they would pay money to get locked into a room. So I'd go out the door on West Street, and I'd march up and down Main Street with brochures, and I'd say, this is why you got to come up here. Go
That's
up there
awesome.
Right there. And I'd have a Sharpie sometimes, and I'd write off, and I'd make them feel like they're getting this special deal. Here's this deal, 30% off. Go up there right now.
Nice.
And eventually, once we, you know, drummed up the business and started to educate people, I didn't have to do that. But
right.
that's what it was when I opened up.
So that shows the passion for it. And,
yeah.
and that, you know, even though you might be doing several different things,
mm-hmm.
one doesn't get any less of your passion than the others.
Yep.
They're kind of, from what I've gathered, the way your mind works and the way you are is you need different outlets for the different parts of your mind. You need this to kind of fulfill your, you know, adventurous, and this for your business and whatever. So
I think it's also, you know, when I was racing, I was, you know, flying every 2 weeks. I'd live in different team owners' homes and in extended stay hotels. And some nights, you know, if we crashed a car or wrecked it, I wasn't the type of driver that would just go back to the hotel. I'd stay there with the crew members and make sure that when that transmission needed to be replaced at 2 a.m, I was there for moral support.
Right.
And that was just all part of having that good
sure.
synergy.
Yeah.
And so I went from this crazy hectic lifestyle of bouncing around all over the country and all these, you know, hotels and all over the place, and then kind of had to hit the real world being
right.
business.
Yeah.
And I think that I pursue all these different endeavors just and I take on all this stress just because it's what I had when I was racing.
Right.
And it's something that I came to love.
Very important question. If you're coming from the racing world,
mm-hmm.
I know that you have the branded Mission Escape Room truck that we saw you rolling. What is your personal car?
Well, so that one I'm going to keep a little bit more quiet.
It does. It fits
it's,
a
it's
racing
all,
lifestyle.
It does.
Okay,
that's
all I need to know. You're not driving around in a Ford Fiesta.
No,
no disrespect.
No.
Ford Fiestas are awesome. But so you still have that in you.
Yes.
That's all I need to
yep.
know. That's okay. That's awesome. Well, before we go, we've covered a lot and we've covered different parts of your life.
Mm-hmm.
What do you want to make sure people know that we haven't touched on? Or what do you want to share that, you know, you think people might enjoy learning?
You know, I just say just always try to do good. You know, even as I've experienced success with Mission Escape Rooms and any other concepts, that I've made sure to always, stay close to my nonprofit, other nonprofits.
Right.
I'm involved with Hospice of the Chesapeake in their committee. You know, I'm an advocate and a spokesperson for Hyundai Hope on Wheels, which is for pediatric oncology research,
okay.
given the history with that.
Yeah.
So just make sure that you never become too big or too good for anyone in it all kind of takes care of itself.
Awesome.
So.
Well, I appreciate your time, and I know we covered a lot of different things at the court. Definitely check out Mission Escape Rooms. Keep an eye out for what he's got coming. You know, I think that we're just going to continue to be surprised by
sure.
what you get into, but I really appreciate it, and I hope that people check you out and keep an eye out and come and see this awesome concept either here in Wachapel or in Annapolis, and hopefully soon you'll be able to get your chocolate fix too.
Yeah.
And if you want any information about any of these businesses or his nonprofit, I'll have links to everything online, so you can definitely check it out further. But thank you so much for joining us. This has been another episode of Coffee and Cocktails with MC. We'll see you next time.
Coffee and Cocktails with MC would like to thank videographer and producer Richard Schulmitz, video editor David Russell, resident mixologist Mimi Evans of Mix & Mimi Mixology, printing and marketing materials from Forbes Printing, and head of marketing Anna Amendelaer of AKA Design. This has been Coffee and Cocktails with MC. We'll see you again next time.